We don't have to fast Saturday now. Okay. This we talk about Saturday, and now let's go Kara to Misal Saum. Misal Saum means you fast continuously. You fast, for example, day and night. But that one is very, we don't have to do it. Because when you do Iyakum Misal, it will prevent from doing Misal. Misal means you want to, that one is very hard. You want to fast day and night, and who can do that? That's very, very hard. He said, it's dislike to do that. And you fast like that continuous, that is, it is do not fit it without breaking it, or suhoor, or without eating the suhoor, it is not going to Islam. It is dislike to Islam. That's why we differ from the non-believers. We eat suhoor, right? We eat suhoor, we break our fast in a night, and also we're gonna eat our suhoor. We don't want misal. All the way, that's gonna be very hard to do. Qala Hasalas, and he said that three times. Iyakum wal misal, do not do misal. And I'm avoiding you to do misal. Stop doing misal. Misal means to fast continuously. The Prophet, you the one, you do wisal. You are telling us not to do wisal, and you are doing wisal. You are fasting like that. And he said, "Innakum lasum fi dhalika misli." You are not like me on that. You are not like me. Why? Because the Prophet and sallallahu alaihi wasallam and us, we have some differences. Why? He said, Inni abitu yut'imuni rabbi wa yasqini. He said, Allah is the one who's feeding you. And he's giving you drink. Allah is the one who's feeding and giving you drink. But it's more strong. If Allah is feeding you and you know Allah is not giving you food, what are you gonna do? You wanna cut him? No. We don't have to do that. He said, Inni abitu yut'imuni rabbi wa yasqini. Faklufu min al-a'mal ma tutiqun. Do what you can do. This one you cannot do it. You cannot do it. Do not cap me on that. Do not cap me on that. This hadith is sahih. Akhrajahu al-Bukhari. This hadith is sahih. Akhrajahu al-Bukhari. That's why the sahab, the companion, they only want to do what the Prophet is doing. But sometimes the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is teaching them a lesson. This one I'm different. We are different on this question. Because Allah is the one who feed me. And he give me drink. That's why don't do this. Okay, but if you don't have any mashaka, any problem by doing that, for example, you say falabas, nothing wrong with that. Because they say this one they dislike. It is not something they say is haram. Something that they say haram and they say dislike is different. Because they say yukra. But this one say, well, you want to. Yeah. Whoever want to do the wisal, you do the wisal until the sihr, then you eat your sihr. For example, you want to do a wisal, continue your wisal until sihr, you start it over there. You start it and do not, you have to eat your suhoor means the one you eat before you start fasting in the early morning. And this hadith is Akhrajahu al-Bukhari. It's narrated, when you go to the book of Bukhari, you're going to find it over there. And this is the thing that we were talking about. Now we have things that you should do and things that you don't have to do. Among them is al-wisal. We know about al-wisal. Okay. Now, inshallah, we are going to Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr, inshallah, I don't think that can we stop here? Because this one is going to be too long, right?
We got more than 30 minutes. We got more than 30 minutes.
We can get another 10 minutes?
No, 30.
30 minutes, inshallah. Okay, now. Fadluha. We have Laylatul Qadr and Fadluha. And قال الله تعالى إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. Why Laylatul Qadr is very important. Laylatul Qadr is the day that is one day, one night that when you worship Allah that night, inshallah, if that day matches Laylatul Qadr, inshallah, you're gonna have a reward of what? Al-Fashr. 10 months. The reward of 10,000 months is how? The reward of 1,000 months is how many days? How many years?
83 years.
83 years and more, right? 83 years. That's a lot of reward. That's why you see the last 10 days people are trying coming to masjid every night to grab that reward. Which is very important to know. Because he said, Laylatul Qadr khayrun min al-fashr. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع. This is why you see people are coming. The angels are coming down to this low heaven. Because they're going to place of zikr. Right? That's why we need to, in a Laylatul Qadr, we need to try our best. As much as we can. If you can do the i'tikaf, that's the best thing. You're gonna grab the Laylatul Qadr. You're gonna get it. If you do the i'tikaf is you do the i'tikaf the last 10 night or the task to day and night. The best thing you do last 10 day and you come to the masjid, you stay there and do the i'tikaf. Until the Ramadan is over, inshallah, you're gonna get the Laylatul Qadr. That's why whoever know that, inshallah, we need to, you know, how you can roll our sleeve. You know what you call rolling our sleeve, tying your belt very tight and come, if you can take off. To come to the masjid so that you're gonna grab that. If you cannot do that, you work daytime. Make sure nighttime you come to the masjid. But it's gonna be very hard. If you work daytime and come to nighttime, it's gonna be very hard. The best thing if you can have, for example, 10 day prayer. If you can have it, that's the best thing. So that you're gonna prepare for yourself. And you shall be in the masjid with everybody and you're gonna grab that reward, inshallah. Because أن الله عز وجل عزم شأنها بذكرها ويقول وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر. And you said the تفسير القرآن بالقرآن, right? What is ليلة القدر? It's a ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن رب. How huge role you could get in it? Allah made it magnify this day. He made it so huge. So that you the one who want to grab it, when you hear this ayah, you're gonna tell myself, I'm going to be ready, inshallah. How many people, they've been fasting for how long? They never grab Laylatul Qadr. Because they always think back home, sleeping. They don't even feel time to come. They don't feel time to come. They think that only Ramadan, that's it. And this 83 years, equivalent to 83 years for us, subhanAllah, we need to do our best. Because we are like the companion. The companion, they used to roll their sleeve and go the Prophet ﷺ used to come in the last 10 night. He used to do the i'tikaf, right? And now the time is too long. Now our iman is going down. It's going down. Look like it's going down until now. We don't need. Even though we talk about Laylatul Qadr, we don't want to come over there. We don't try to urge the friends. And tell them Laylatul Qadr, let's make sure that let's not miss this Laylatul Qadr. Because of the big reward. That's why you see someone who's fasting, he was very bad before the Ramadan. And after Ramadan, he rolled his sleeve and tried to do the praying at night and fasting. And everything that broke his Ramadan, he's not going to do. He stopped doing that. Until Laylatul Qadr, and he's worked very hard again. And come to the masjid every night to do the Laylatul Qadr. Now what happened? Subhanallah. That's why you see someone who's doing bad until you have a zira, a little bit less to form to go and help by and do good thing and go to paradise. This person after Ramadan he passed away. He's gonna go to paradise. Because Allah bless him with this. And he woke Ramadan. How many last year after Ramadan till now? How many people that we know that they passed away? I think you can, each one could say, I know someone who passed away. I heard someone who passed away, and they were Muslim like us. They were doing their best. And we don't know even if Allah blesses with this Ramadan. Next Ramadan, we don't know if we're going to be alive. That's why you have to grab that book. As much as you can, try to grab Laylatul Qadr as much as you can, inshallah. Because he said, أن العبادة فيها خير من العبادة في ألف شهر ليس فيها ليلة القدر. He said, that night is better than thousand months that the month that there is nothing, ليلة القدر is not there. For that, what he said, when you do the ليلة القدر and you grab that ليلة القدر, he said it's better than thousand months. And we just talk about it. Because أن الملائكة تنزل في هذا الليل. He said the angel, they're going to descend. They're going to come down to this in that night. The angel going to come down to that night. With the mercy. They bring a lot of mercies. Bir Rahman, wal barakat, and blessings. Wa sakina, and tranquility. That night you're going to see a night of tranquility. The night of mercy. The night of what? Of Rahman. The night of barakat, blessing. Why don't we go and get the night of mercy, the night of blessing, and the night of mercy. All of these are the that night, you're going to see all of this. All the angels are coming down. And تَتْنَزُلْ بِكُلِّ أَمْرٍ قَضَاهُ اللَّهُ. They bring everything Allah will decree it before. They're gonna have this, you're gonna have this, your job is gonna change. For them, Allah is the one who gives them that permission. Anything they do is with the permission of Allah. They cannot do anything without the permission of Allah. That's why he said, بِكُلِّ أَمْرٍ قَضَاهُ اللَّهُ وَقَدَّرَهُ لِهَذِهِ السَّنَةِ for that year. They're gonna come that year, they're gonna come this year, you're gonna have this. This year, this person gonna have this. This year, this person gonna have this. This year, this person gonna become a scholar. This year, this person gonna become rich. This year, you're gonna become a good person. You're gonna start practicing the religion. This year, you're gonna have this type of money. This year, this person gonna die. This year, everything. They're gonna come and busy doing that. Because that's the job that Allah gave them. Right? That's why that night, if you are over there and you are worshiping Allah as Allah wants, one of the best. That's the one of the best to worship Allah that day. And we're gonna come to all of the signs. We're gonna have signs that come. Which sign that we're gonna see to know that this Allah is coming. And that one, inshallah, we're gonna because Anna wasalam means this the tranquility. And peace. You're gonna see that the tranquility in that night. You're gonna see that peace everywhere. It's spread everywhere. Ala ahli iman. He said, ala ahli iman, those who have the people of iman. It doesn't mean now, yeah, I'm a bad person. No, only for the ahli iman. If you feel that in your heart, and you know that, inshallah, that's a good sign that maybe you are doing your best at least, right? For the early, the people of iman. And iman, we know what is iman. We have Islam and we have iman, we have ihsan. Right? And if you have ihsan, you have iman at the same time. If you have iman, you have to work more hard to get to ihsan. Right? But early iman, those who believe, those who have the people of iman, those who believe in Allah. That's why, if you feel that tranquil in that Laylatul Qadr, know that inshallah, have confidence that inshallah you are among them. You have confidence that inshallah you are among the people of iman. And he continues saying that in that night he said the an Abi radiyallahu anhu narrated from Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam قال من صام رمضان إيمانا وحده غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه ومن قام ليلة القدر إيمانا وحده غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه سبحان الله. Who say whoever stand that night, Laylatul Qadr, iman and wahtisaba, with full belief, complete belief, wahtisaba, and seeking reward, right? Ghufra lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi, your past sins are forgiven. Imagine that night you come and you don't sleep, you stay in the mosque doing zikr, remember Allah, praying, doing tahajjud, until you meet that night, inshallah, your past sins are forgiven. That's very important to know. That night, it is a huge night. we need to make, even though everyone not to come to the masjid, to make the masjid packed with people, so that we're going to single Allah out, we're going to remember Allah, we're going to pray, we're going to heard a lot of good stuff, inshallah. That Laylatul Qadr is very important. Imanan wa taqwa ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi Because la shak anna Laylatul Qadr fi Ramadan liqawli sallam inna anzalna fi Laylatul Qadr. We reveal it in the day, in the night of the Qadr. Means Al-Qur'an. And the end of the hadith, the end of the ayah said, Shahru Ramadan allazi unzila fihi. The month of Ramadan that the Quran was revealed in the month. The Quran was revealed in the month of Ramadan and was in the night of the Laylatul Qadr. Was in the night of the Laylatul Qadr. That's why wal aktharun ala anna fil ashr awal. A lot of people they said, if you want to seek Laylatul Qadr, make sure you seek in the last 10 nights. Some people they single out only 37. You don't see them in a masjid at all. Even though sometimes they don't come to masjid to trawe, some people. But when the 27 comes, they say this right away. You're gonna see them back, come to the masjid, all of them bring food and alhamdulillah, it's something, it's good. But they may miss Laylatul Qadr. They may miss Laylatul Qadr. The only one, inshallah, is not the one that who's not gonna miss Laylatul Qadr, the one who come the whole 10 nights. And you worship Allah in those 10 nights. And you sincere to Allah, singling out Allah. But those who only choose only one night is not the right way to do. It's not the right way to do. And that's why he said, كيف هذه الليلة مر من حرمها فقط حرم فقط ولا يحرم خيرها إلا محروم. He said, whoever missed this Laylatul Qadr, Subhanallah, you are mahroom. You are mahroom. You are loser. You are loser. This night, whoever missed, he said, is a loser. Because a huge night that you more than 83 years reward, right? And you miss this night, Subhanallah. That one, the people they call him. You wanna know the loser? The real loser is the one that who missed the Laylatul Qadr. That's why we need to make sure to grab this, as I said, all the time. And then he said, "Narrated from Aisha radiallahu anha, qalat," he said, "Kana Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam yattahidu ma la yattahidu fi ghayriha." He used to do all his effort on these 10 days as than others. With when these 10 days, you're going to see him use doing all effort to increase his worship Allah, increasing his ibadah. He's very generous, right? He's giving, he's doing all this type of good stuff, good thing. That's why it's our role model. We have to copy him, inshallah. That's why whoever want to grab this level, make sure you come the last 10 nights. The best thing to do the i'tikaf. The best thing is to do i'tikaf. I'tikaf is you come to the masjid, you bring all your stuff with you. You have big bag and put your clothes, everything. And you take shower in the masjid. You stay in the masjid day and night until the Ramadan and until those 10 days are over. A lot of people, alhamdulillah, in New York, a lot of people are doing it. You're gonna see in Ramadan some masjid that they have shower and everything. You're gonna see they pack up their bags and they put all your stuff and they go, they look like they're going to vacation, Subhanallah. And you're gonna see them in the masjid, staying in the masjid day and night. They take 10 days off or they take 1 month vacation. You go to prepare, in order to prepare that, Right? And there's some people, they're gonna travel from here to all the way to Makkah to do their Laylatul Qadr over there. Some people all the way to Medina to do their Laylatul Qadr over there. They i'tikaf over there. That's why if you know that, if you never done in your life i'tikaf, please try at least. If you are able to do it, try to. One day you said, this year I'm gonna do i'tikaf day and night without going out. That will teach you a lot. you teach you a lot of lessons. But a lot of people, they don't know the beauty of doing i'tikaf. If you never done, you don't know the beauty of doing i'tikaf. It is beautiful. If you never tried, please try it at least one Ramadan. One Ramadan, you say, this Ramadan, inshallah, last night, I'm gonna look like you are traveling. You pack up your everything, tell you, go to the one masjid that, huh?
If they have specifically mosque, do that. Isn't that all mosque?
No, it's
like this mosque you can do.
Why?
You only got
to. Yeah, the problem is, this masjid, if sometimes some masjid, they don't have a shower. But we have a lot of masjid over here in New York, they have place to take shower. A lot of masjid, when you go there, they have place to take shower. If you really search for it, you're gonna find it. If you really search for it, make sure at least before you pass away, make sure you do at least one time i'tikaf.
No.
Yeah.
We really need to go to the masjid to stay there. You can just pray the night and come back home.
But that one, the reward will decrease, right?
No, it's
far. I'tikaf, you have the best of i'tikaf to stay in the masjid day and night.
But
you can do one day i'tikaf, you can do 2 day i'tikaf, you can do 3, even though you cannot do the 10 day i'tikaf, at least do 1 day i'tikaf, do 2 day i'tikaf, do 3 day i'tikaf, do as much as you can. But if you know that you can do 10 day, just do the whole 10 day, to come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to do that. And look at that, you have greater chance to grab the level of. That's the main thing. 83 years reward, big huge reward. You do the i'tikaf and you do it because Allah, look at that.
So people think that the i'tikaf is only for Ramadan. But the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did it in Shawwal. There's an authentic hadith that he did it other months too. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was asked for Ramadan to call him a nazar to nazar. He made a nazar to do i'tikaf for Allah one day and night. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told him, he told him that his nazar was before Islam, in January, he told him to do wafat, to do simple nazar. I mean, that it was 3 years before this.
Yeah, but the best i'tikaf is the Ramadan. Let's take the Ramadan one, because the Ramadan, you're going to meet Laylatul Qadr. But in other, you may not meet the Laylatul Qadr, but the best one is to grab the Laylatul Qadr. Let's make it and do the day and night to grab the Laylatul Qadr. If you are able to do it, any masjid, it doesn't mean you have to do it in this masjid. Any masjid you think that you feel comfortable, they have enough shower to take shower. Inshallah, take your stuff. Let those masjid know that you, inshallah, you're going to do i'tikaf over there. If they're going to welcome you, inshallah, you go over there, you know, reading Quran and listening to ahadith, nabawiyah, and tafsir. All of this is very important. If you're able to do it, please. i'tikaf is very, make sure before you die, at least you do it one time, the 10 day. That's the best thing, to copy the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why, as I mentioned, say, man qama laylatul qadr iman wa ihtasaba ghufira lahu ma taqaddam. It's not only that the 83, the reward of 1,000 months, Allah will forgive your past sin. Sometimes maybe those sins could lead you to hellfire. And Allah forgive your sin like that, right? That's very important. Let's make sure Laylatul Qadr, inshallah, let's not. If it is i'tikaf, you cannot do i'tikaf, make sure you try to do at least one day i'tikaf, 2 day i'tikaf, 3 day, as I mentioned. If you get 3 day i'tikaf, it's good. Day and night, right? Inshallah, if you choose not to do it, it's not good, well, because you're not gonna. If you don't come to the masjid. The last time you don't come to me at all, you may not grab the Laylatul Qadr.
Like if you call me in the night, every night you call me. That is.
Yeah, night. The Laylatul Qadr is night. You can come at night to grab the Laylatul. Inshallah, you're gonna grab it.
Well.
You stay with the people in the masjid and inshallah you're gonna grab the Laylatul Qadr. If you come at all ten night, inshallah.
But it's two different things. It's still happening. Yeah.
Yeah, i'tikaf and qiyam is different. I'tikaf, qiyamul layl, you have qiyamul layl, tahajjud, we call it tahajjud. Why are you doing i'tikaf? You do the tahajjud, qiyamul layl. You grab this, you grab Allah. By doing i'tikaf, you're going to grab a lot, you're going to have a lot of reward. That's why the importance of doing that. You're going to have Because we say if even though you grab the Laylatul Qadr, man qama Laylatul Qadr, you grab the Laylatul Qadr, you make sure you that day you come and it is Laylatul Qadr, inshallah your pass, Allah gonna forgive your pass. Your pass 1 year. Ma kufra ma taqaddam, the one your pass it. It doesn't mean your 1 year passing or 2 years or 3 years, he said ma taqaddam min dhalik. Right? That's why it's very important. It's very important. Inshallah, if you know that, let's try our best. It is hard. We are busy. Really, we are busy doing a lot of stuff. But you can you know schedule it and tell yourself now. Inshallah, I'm gonna make sure Laylatul Qadr, the last ten day, I'm gonna take off. I'm just wanna busy worshiping Allah. In all those nights, you know, every night Allah gonna come to the lower heaven. Whoever asks him, he will give you. And you may ask something was very hard for you, and you get it that night. You get it that night. Or you ask Allah, make my things easy at all time. You're going to see yourself, anything you want, Allah going to make it easy. Right? Sometimes we have so many things that to do that to Allah make our things very easy. But we are so lazy. We don't want to walk the walk. We don't want to get up and go and do it. But you get something, you have to work very hard, right? You have to get up, you're sleeping and doing tahajjud and i'tikaf. You come to the masjid 10 night, leave your job for 10 days. How many? Much money, a lot of money. But you do it because of Allah. Because anything you do because of Allah, Allah will replace it with something better than that. Make sure your heart, you do it because of Allah. Inshallah, the time is rich because. And we will talk about the next time. We're going to talk about the signs of Laylatul Qadr. How do you know this night is Laylatul Qadr? Inshallah, we're going to talk tomorrow. Inshallah, we're going to talk about that. Inshallah. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah.
Amin.